Hey there everybody, Eric from Outer Limitless coming at you today with another video. Now in today's video, we're gonna talk about slings, whether or not to go with the 2-point application or a 1-point application. Now here in my hands, this is the Mossberg 590 Thunder Ranch Edition. I've recently gotten my own shotgun. I've been going out to the range practicing, and well, part of that is carrying your firearm. And for me, and I need to premise this entire video with a couple of things. First, I am very much a novice. This is my very first shotgun that I've personally owned. I've shot a little bit in the past, but at this point, really getting into it for myself for the first time. And so, well, I am a novice. If you are an expert or the seasoned veteran, somebody who's been around for a while and has some good practical experience, well, if there's anything I've learned from running my primary Outer Limitless YouTube channel, well, you guys have a ton to offer. So please weigh in. I'd love to hear some comments and maybe get some tips and tricks that might be helpful both to me and to other people who are watching. But so yeah, it's one thing to have a firearm. If you intend on using it for self-defense, if you intend on using it for sport, it might be another. For me personally, well, I really want to use my shotgun for the sport application, like 99, if not 199% of the time. Do I really want to use this for a self-defense situation? No. If I had to, would I? I don't know. We'll figure it out if we get there. But in the meantime, I'm using this for sport. And so there are a few things. I've tried carrying this a few different ways. For the most part, with the 2-point sling, it's just not so comfortable for me and my style and the way I feel like I would excel. You know, having it slung over my shoulder, that's not necessarily the best. I really like something across my chest. Now, you can do that with a 2-point sling, but for me, it was just sitting awkward. It didn't feel quite right. And more than anything else, I wasn't happy with coming up into my mount smooth, efficient, and effectively time and time again. So my consistency just wasn't there. Now, granted, I'll give you that. If I practiced more and more and more, would I get better? Would I get more proficient? Of course I would, but I am also learning. I like to experiment. And so in this video, we're gonna get away from this 2-point and go to a 1-point solution. That for me, I think is gonna be just about perfect. And so with that said, I have a whole bunch to do and a whole bunch to share with you. And if you're interested in seeing a little bit more about what I'm about to get into, do me a favor, stay tuned. And so here you can see my Mossberg 590 at this point with the 1-point sling. Now it took a little bit to get here. What we're gonna do, we're gonna go through the process of installing this in its Grove Tech shotgun side mount. So this side mount here, you can see right on the side of the receiver, working out extremely well. Now you can also see some additional accessories here, which I'll cover in another video, but this is the end result. And the rest of this video here kind of taking me through part of the process getting this mounted. So what we're gonna do now, we're gonna cut to that footage. We're gonna take a look at it and you can see how I converted from a 2-point sling to a 1-point solution. And so now first things first, you do need to punch the pin out of the receiver. So very easy. This pin here is replaced with the adapter that's sent with part of the Grove Tech shotgun side mount adapter. They call this the stud head. So basically at this point, getting it installed, very straightforward, and adding some Loctite to ensure that it does not come off. Now you can notice here that I do have this run in one particular direction, getting this roughly into place and cleaning it up. This happens to be on the right-hand side of the receiver. Now I'm leveraging the Uncle Mike stainless steel nickel quick detach sling swivels to attach my sling right onto the side post and the stud head. These are very easy to use and extremely quick and very sturdy. Clipping my sling right to this, you can see. Now getting some advice from some people to put this on the right hand side of the receiver, you can see here for me personally, this is not necessarily the best. I find that the actual stock kind of gets in the way and this doesn't hang as even or as easy as I would like. So taking the stud head, reversing sides, well here, this is definitely much better. So putting it on the left hand side of the receiver, that works much better for me. This single point sling, very easy.
to get up into the firing position, the mount on the gun much easier, and my ability to actually control the firearm at my side works out very well with my hand on the stock and also on the barrel. Now, at this point, I am able to fully tighten up on this using some Loctite to ensure that this doesn't come loose, and getting this tightened up, no problem at all. Just being careful with a set of pliers, you'll notice that the mounting head does have a little bit of a knurling on it, which allows you to grab onto it, no problem. And at this point, this is working out extremely well. Very straightforward, very easy, and most people with basic mechanical skills should be able to install this without any difficulty.
And so the two-point sling I have here, this is from Beechin Tactical. So Jacob Peterson of Beechin Tactical, Exodus Knife and Tool, and the Prepper's Bunker Outdoors. He makes some just absolutely beautiful slings, and well, I have a two-point sling here. I might be reaching out to him for a one-point sling. So here I have a couple of different slings. This one here from Midway USA, and this just a simple, cheap option from Amazon.com. Both of which actually have some desirable features. Neither one of these is perfect. And I guess at this point it leaves me with some questions for the audience, but I'll get to that in just a second. So this one here from Midway USA, this is the Bungee Single Point in Wolf Gray. And things I like about it, I definitely do like the bungee. It kind of absorbs a little bit of the weight of the firearm, which is nice. Kind of takes a little bit of the sort of stress off your shoulders and does seem to do a fairly good job. I like the overall hardware. I think they did a great job. This point right here being nice and articulated, doing a good job to allow everything to kind of move and contour the way it needs to. And then you can see here, just a Duraflex style buckle. Looking at it, it does not appear to be actual Duraflex, but it's sort of similar. In fact, looking a little closer, it's an ITW Nexus buckle, which ITW buckles a good positive click if you listen there. So nice and durable. Now, the thing that I don't necessarily like about this, and it's a little bit of a shame, but I'm not gonna let it bother me. Well, if you look at this cheap one from Amazon, and now that I'm into this, the hardware is not nearly as nice, but what I do like is this little sort of shock collar around the actual buckle, and that's gonna be nice because the clip here could potentially damage your finish if you care. I don't think I do too much. In fact, I always talk about the fact that I like a good hard use patina, and if that means that my sling and my clip has been sort of rubbing against the finish, well, that's because I'm carrying it. So good hard use patina never really bothers me. However, I do think that just for general protection of your firearm and keeping it a little bit quieter, not clanking around, and of course not damaging your finish, just having a little bit of that bungee would have been nice around here and just making it a little more protected. But all in all, I can't say I can complain too much. This Midway sling is definitely pretty nice. And the Amazon one, again, not bad, also has that bungee. Now this is a little bit sort of, I would say a lighter pull. They're about the same. Actually, it looks like it might have even a little more travel, which who knows if that's really important. Nice sort of three-way connection here. That's very sound. Nice, thick, and durable plastic. And then, you know, reasonable buckles. Again, kind of nondescript. I don't see any markings on here, so a little bit generic. Not the best in terms of, like, hard click. So they might be a little bit cheaper, but at the same time, for very short money, I'm talking like 15 bucks or less, this could definitely get you started. And you can see here, it's sort of set up a little bit for, you know, one way or the other. It looks like it's kind of contoured just a little bit the way it's constructed. And so now the question for me is, how do I actually mount this every time? Well, do I put it over my sort of support shoulder? Do I put it over my trigger shoulder? You know, which is the best way to go? I'm still gonna be experimenting with that. I kind of have a long way to go with it, but all in all, definitely thinking the single point sling is what I'm gonna like the best. And so, all right, there you have it, getting my Mossberg 590 set up with a single point sling. Now leveraging some good hardware, the Grove Tech side mount here, working very well, actually just about perfect for me, leveraging a couple nice slings. So here again, the Midway sling and also the one from Amazon, both reasonable, doing a pretty good job. However, I do think that for me, again, this being just a little bit on the long side, and then the firearm just hanging down a little bit too low, it would work out a little better to my advantage to potentially have it just a little shorter. I mean, for me, I really don't want this hanging down quite as low. coming up just a little higher. That means I do need maybe a couple inches less material. Now this is cinched up literally as much as it can. So when I first started saying, well, I had the 2-point sling from Beach and Tactical, I will probably now, and I would say almost definitely now, go with the 1-point sling. But anyway, having the single point sling solution working out extremely well, able to mount very comfortably, and just fitting my style. Again, just trying to find my way through this, find what works, figure out things that are pros and cons. So again, if you are that seasoned veteran and you have anything to add to this, please leave some comments below. And for the rest of you, if you like this content, well, do me a favor, take a look at my Outer Limitless YouTube channel, which is my primary channel. I have reviews and videos on everything from outdoor excursions, hiking, camping, backpacking, trips, all the different gear, everything from shelters, sleeping bags, backpacks, knives, axes, flashlights, you name it. That's my Outer Limitless YouTube channel. So, all right, guys, thanks for stopping by. I hope you like what you saw. I hope you found it a little bit informative. If you like what you saw, please like, share, and subscribe. And as always, thanks for stopping by. Take care now. I'll see you soon.